Today we're going to be working on lead code question number 146, LRU cache. Design a data structure that follows the constraints of a least recently used LRU cache. Implement the LRU cache class. We're going to have a capacity, which is basically going to initialize the cache, positive size capacity. Then we're going to have mainly two functions. The get function is going to return the value of the key if the key exists, otherwise it's gonna return -1, and the other one is gonna be equal to put int key int value, update the key of value of the key if the key exists, otherwise add value key value pair to the cache. If the number of keys exceed the capacity of this operation, evict the least recently used key. Okay, the functions get and put must each run in O of 1 average time complexity. So in this example, this is a detailed example. LRU cache is basically initializing it with 2, and both of them are like basically they're gonna test it using test our code using these inputs. So when LRU cache is used and the capacity has been defined, we are actually setting the LRU cache of size 2. Then we are putting 1 with a key, putting key and value as 1, 1. Then we are putting key and value as 2, 2, and then we are getting 1, so we will be able to return it. Then we are getting 1, then we are putting 3 and 3, so basically this is gonna get replaced because this is not recently used. Then we are getting the value of 2, which is gonna be -1. Okay, and then we're gonna be putting 4 and 4, which is basically gonna be replacing 1. Okay, and when the 1 is being asked, it's -1 because that's been removed. 2, 3, and 4 were asked, and the values of those keys will be returned. Okay, for this case, what we're gonna be doing is like we're gonna have our own class of nodes. So let's say what our node looks like. So our node is gonna be like we have a key value and a previous node, because we're gonna be doing it using a doubly linked list. So our node is gonna look like just like this one. We're gonna do self. We're gonna do K and V. Basically, key and value are being given to the node. So once we are initializing node, what we're gonna be doing is like we're gonna say self dot key, which is equal to K, and self dot value, which is equal to V, and self dot previous, which is equal to none, and self dot next, which is equal to none. Okay, so this is basically how we're gonna be initializing our nodes. So the LRU cache object, the way that is gonna look like is when we initialize that, what is gonna happen is like we're gonna set the first thing is that setting the capacity. So for that, we're gonna say that self dot capacity is equal to capacity. Okay, the next thing we're gonna say that self dot dictionary is gonna be equal to an empty dictionary. Okay, then we're gonna have two things. We're gonna have self dot head and self dot tail. Self dot head is basically initialized as 0 key and 0 value. And self dot okay, and actually the we can have the 0 and 0 because this is like how we're gonna be treating it. Although we are using zeros, but it is because like it is not really like because we can have multiple values. So 0, 0 is like if we could have set it to anything actually, and it should have worked. It's not like because the value can be a key and value can be literally anything. Okay, the reason for that is that we are creating a like an LRU cache, although we are using a dictionary, but like it's a cache and we can keep an eye on it, like which one is being recently used. So doesn't matter how we really initialize it. The next one is going to be the tail, which is again a node, and we're going to initialize it with 0, 0. Okay, and now what is going to happen is like our tail, which is going to be at the end, where we're going to be our tail is going to be at the end where we're going to be removing the elements, and head is going to we're going to be adding the elements. So we're going to say that our tails next is going to be equal to self dot head. Okay, and our heads previous is definitely gonna be equal to the tail. Okay, now coming to the get one. Okay, so the get is gonna say that if the key is inside this dictionary, right, what you have to do is like first of all you have to first of all, like if it is in the key, what we're gonna be doing is like we're gonna say that okay, our n is equal to self dot dictionary with that key. With that key, and then we're gonna say that we're gonna call our function. So basically, we know the value which we're gonna be returning, which is gonna be n. But we need to remove that that node. So for that, we're gonna be doing calling a function called self dot underscore remove that n, and then we're gonna adding it again. So self dot underscore add n, and then we're going to be returning n negative value, n dot value. If it is not in the dictionary, we're going to be returning negative 1. Okay, now the other function is the put function. For the put function, we're going to, first of all, the same way, we're going to check that whether or not the key is in the dictionary, right? If the key is in the dictionary, all you have to do is like you're gonna be removing it, right, and then just putting it as a new node. So and in the end we're gonna check the size of the current size of the dictionary. So if key inside the self dot dictionary, we're gonna say that self dot underscore remove self dot dictionary, del dot dictionary key. So all we are saying is like if you already have it in there, we're gonna remove it because we just wanna keep it simple, and then we wanna put it again, and then we're gonna have a node with key and value, right? That's what we are being given. Yes, the key and the value. So we're gonna have a key and a value, and then we're gonna say self dot underscore add this n, and then self dot dictionary with that key is gonna become equal to that node. So remember, this dictionary is basically not just the key and value, it's the key to our node, and the node has its own value. That being said, the last thing we want to check is like if the capacity has been increased, if the length of the self dot dictionary is basically more that self dot pass array. If that is the case, we're gonna say that as basically we're gonna say that what is the like what is the previous value of the node of the tail, right? Oh, sorry, what is the next the next value of the tail? So self dot tail, because that's what we so what is the tails previous value, right? The tails previous value. Okay, and we're gonna remove the n self dot underscore remove n, and then we're gonna delete it from the dictionary to self dot dictionary n dot k. Yes, so we are removing it from the so the n is basically we are saying that the tails previous value, because our head is where we want to add things, right? As we're going to do it when we're going to be implementing our underscore add and underscore remove functions. So our tails previous one is where we yes, because the tails next is basically gonna be not pointing to any node, so it's the previous one which we wanna get. Yes, and then that's gonna be our n. Sounds good. Now the last two things are like we're gonna implement underscore remove, which is self and node. So once you want to remove something, it's very easy. You say that get the node's previous, like store it, okay, and get the node's next, and then just remove the node itself. So previous dot next is gonna be equal to n, and n dot previous is gonna be equal to p. That is very straightforward. The last thing is we wanna do add self node. So for that, our previous, if you are trying to add something, what we decided is like we're gonna be adding as a we're gonna be adding it on the head of the like we're gonna be basically adding it at the head. So we're gonna say that what is the previous, or actually what is the next value on our head, right? Self dot head dot next, like what was okay, and then we're gonna say that that is was the next, right? So we got the next one. Now for the next one, we're gonna say that okay, that next dot previous is basically equal to that new node, okay, and then our heads next is gonna be equal to that new node, and then the node next is gonna be equal to that n, and then the node previous is gonna be equal to self dot next. Oh, sorry, self dot head Yes, that's how we're gonna, because we are trying to error in the like just after the head. Okay. We can't assign function called dictionary and okay. Should be key is equal to the n node. Noun type object, no attribute previous. Type object has no attribute previous. Dot next. What we were trying to do, we got the n right. So we were just saying that the heads next is gonna be equal to n, but the n's previous is equal to node. But he didn't like it. Noun type object has no attribute previous. It does not have. Okay. I think what we're gonna be doing here, instead of actually putting it in the on the top. That's okay. Okay, so what we're gonna be doing here. Yeah. What we're gonna be doing here is like, instead of actually. Okay. Capacity head. Okay. Yeah. What we are going to do is like, instead of putting things on the head, what we're going to be doing is like, we're going to be putting the new incoming nodes like like on the tail. So basically the logic is going to be like, we're going to initialize our head dot next equals to the tail. So our heads is going to be basically everything which we're gonna be remove is from the head, everything which we're gonna be putting in is from the tail, right? So the head dot next is gonna be equal to the tail, and the tail's previous is basically gonna be equal to the head. Okay. Okay. Wait, Ibrahim, 1 minute. Okay, now this is good. Get is good. Inside the pod, what we're going to be doing is like everything is good, but when we're going to repeat, it depends where we're going to be putting it. So we're going to be putting it in the head's next value. So the new node which we're going to be putting in is going to be on the head's next, like after the head, we're gonna be putting that in. Okay, and the only thing which is gonna get changed is that the remove one, when we are removing, when we are adding a new one, we're gonna be adding it to the tail's previous one, because now we wanna put things at the tail end. wanna be like tail dot previous is gonna be equal to the node, and in the end our nodes dot previous is gonna be equal to with the one which we already saved, and the next node dot next is basically gonna be equal to the tail, as we are putting it everything inside the new elements are gonna be node instead of new attribute value. I think this should be value. Yes. Looking good. Yep, and it did pass. So yeah, we ended up putting the new nodes at the next to the tail, and every time the new elements are gonna be put in next to the tail. We're putting the new elements from the tail side, and we're removing the element from the head side. Yeah, we already submitted that. Yep.